apologize for my English in advance. I use a lot of videos, so you can only watch it. I'm Del Checa. I came from University of Burgos. It's a little one in the north of Spain. And this work I do with Mario Laguero and Andres Bustillo is virtual reality immersive serious game to enhance learning. And the outline of the presentation will be as follows. First, the motivation and objectives. Second, the development and the evaluation and conclusion. So, beginning with the motivations, I'm part of 3DU. It's a little research group centering virtual reconstruction. And as you can see, we work with virtual reality for several years. First with caves, but in the last years we with the democratization of this hardware, we can face a lot of projects, and like this one that has no money at all. So Mario has talked about the portable virtual reality one, and now I use like high-end virtual reality. The difference between this is like maybe you say, maybe you know, one is only a 360 render, and in this solution the environment is complete and you can get close to things or interact with them. So in the past we have previous experience in virtual reality to enhance the understanding of this strongly degraded or lost heritage. This is Briviesca's our last project in this kind of research, and we develop a serious game in virtual reality to enhance the learning of this village that have changed a lot. I told you this because it's the starting point of this now work. In this case, we use virtual reality and compare it to a video we developed to disseminate this knowledge. And the results we have is that students have a preference for the virtual reality experience, but the video seems to be a better option to transmit these historical topics, like the dates of the foundation of the city or the name of the king. But on the other hand, the people who play the virtual reality serious game achieve better understanding of things that are not implicit in the narrative, like the materials of the houses or the height, the things that we don't tell to them, but they catch, like allocation of the objects in the city. So in this first case, we use virtual reality compared to only a video, and now we want to go further and compare this virtual reality with a video game. So the objectives of this project are, first, the recreation in virtual reality of only a part of this settlement. Then, with this environment port to the game engine, and with the same environment, design a serious game that can be played in virtual reality by the Oculus Rift and in a traditional game with a third-person view of a character. And finally, assess the acquired knowledge about this archaeological reconstruction. So I'm not talking about this because Mario has done before. So my part in this project begins with they have all the models. The modelers work with researchers, with archaeologists, and they bring me like all these models and the composition, in this case in Blender. And what I do is translate it to the game engine. In this case, this is Blender, and I port to Unreal Engine. That is what we use, and yeah, you can see some renders of this environment that have to be running in real time, at least 90 photograms per second. And when we have this environment created, it's time to start to do the interactions and that have to work with the virtual reality experience and the traditional video game with a keyboard or with a gamepad. So we design a little experience. This is the short one because the game will be bigger in the future, but we create the game design document, and for this example we only want to test a little part of this game to see if that everything is working and if we have some error, some mistakes or something like this that can be solved. This is an example of the virtual reality game. The users only see their hands and they can teleport to this environment and can interact with almost everything in the game. And the other game is exactly in the same environment, but they play with a game board and control and character. So when we finish these two games, it's time to evaluate the knowledge about these games, and we use our talents, 20 talents. We try once the virtual reality game and others the traditional game, and like 60% of people doesn't have a virtual reality high-end experience before. The motion sickness that was a problem for us in the past with the development kit of Oculus now is reduced, but is still somehow present, and we are trying to lower. And there are some questions about what game they like. Also, if the game has increased the interest about this history, this statement, and as you can see, virtual reality have better retention in both. And this is at least a bit strange because this asks about the graphic quality of the game, and both games are exactly the same environment, so the graphic quality is identical, but people who play with the virtual reality think that graphics are better. I think it's because they can interact with things and get closer to it and like appreciate the models. Also, in knowledge retention, we ask in two parts. The first about the knowledge retention that are not implicit. It's like we ask here if they have seen the focus screens in the game that are in a part, but in virtual reality, like half of people see them and can respond correctly, and in the 2D screen, these are lower. But on the other hand, when we ask about things we told to him, like what's the name of the chief house like, in virtual reality there are lack of this knowledge. This can be prevent, I think, because we told these things at the beginning of the game, and as you see, most people has first experience in virtual reality, so they are enjoying the experience and didn't listen too much to it. So, and finally, the conclusions. we see that there are preference for this virtual reality experience. That the in both games the users enjoy the interaction. They highlight it in both games that you can pick everything or talk to the characters. And also in virtual reality they highlight the interaction with the hands, but it has two sides because I find that more people begin to pick things and throw and have fun. So I think we have to take advantage of this, but it's a bit strange. And finally, that the video game appeared to be a better option to transmit this implicit knowledge, and the virtual reality more for this visual accurate knowledge. And for future lanes, now we have all the model, they are texturing it, and when they finish, we will perform this serious game with that we have learned in this little test to the final game. So, thanks.